My job is first year coordinator, which means I take a group of students who've never studied geology before in their life, and I teach them how to view the world through a geologist's eyes. I like being able to understand what's going on. So for me, geology helps to explain what you see when you look at the world around you. So if you understand what's happening, you can work out what's going to happen next. You can look at anything and see its history. Just by, you know, looking at a rock or a hill or a river, you can basically decipher the world. My main research interest outside teaching undergrad students is I'm one of a group of people who helped to select landing sites for Mars rovers. And the main reason I do this is because a lot of the Earth is now really explored. There are still places we don't know a lot about, like Antarctica and Greenland and Iceland and things like that. But Mars is a whole planet just waiting to be discovered. I'm seeing photos every day that are coming back from the orbiters around Mars that perhaps, you know, 10, 20 other people on this planet have seen. Mars is the most Earth-like of the other planets in our solar system in terms of it may potentially have life on it, which is what we're trying to find out with the rovers that are currently up there. And it is also the one that we're focusing most attention on. So it's easy to get data from it. There's lots of orbiters. There's now two rovers active on the surface. We actually know a lot more about Mars than we know about the Earth in some ways.
Wait, where's French Island?
Somewhere.
Imbolaa.
Yeah, it'll be down there.
Somewhere here.
Awesome. So you're going to be basically wandering along that bit of coast, looking.
When I suddenly realised that they've gone from looking at the sand at a beach and thinking, oh yeah, that's getting stuck to my feet, and looking at the sand at a beach and realising that it used to be a granite which was formed 20 kilometres under the surface of the Earth when two continents collided perhaps half a billion years ago. That for me is pretty amazing. And that's what I love.
These are my first year geology students. These are students who've done two semesters of geology now, and they've learnt about stuff in prep classes and they've seen small chunks of rock, but it's not quite the same as coming down here and actually looking at them up close and personal, even if it is in the pouring rain. You're standing on a river valley. What you see today is not the way it was 115 million years ago. And hopefully what you're going to be learning today whilst you're down here will actually allow you to understand how things have changed and why they've changed. This is the time when you can actually see light bulbs go off in their heads, when they can actually use the knowledge that we've shown them in prep classes. So previously it's all been theoretical. They've had a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Here in this field site, they actually get to put it all together and they see that we're not just making it up. It actually really does exist. This is the moment where they actually learn how to see things, not just look at them. I've been digging here at the dinosaur dig as one of the volunteers for 20 years. So I've found quite a few dinosaur bones and teeth and jaws and a little bit of mammal and other bits and pieces. So yeah, I try to spend a week or two each year down here as a volunteer if I can, because it's fun.